We'll step off now before this is what I'm trying to hustle. We've got a really nice undulations all the way up to 900. Then we'll go down to temps 2, temps 1, where we'll stop and have a break. Have a late lunch today, looking at temps 1 later on this afternoon, but we'll have some breaks on the way. Not a lot, but it's just really pretty scenic. Okay.
Was phenomenal, yeah, like stepping back in time, eh? And then you walk out of it and you've got all these beautiful flowers around you too.
This is 1900, funnily enough, because we're at 1895 meters. They ran out of really cool names for all the other beautiful places, so this place called 1900. So we're about, 200 meters below the highest point. So we'll come out of here, we'll punch up sort of 250 meters to the top of Mount Bellamy. And that's the highest point. So metaphorically, it's all downhill from there. Yeah?
Day 5, beautiful morning, rocking it. Everything feels better after day 4.
A bit easier this morning, which is really nice. We went through the moss forest, which is just amazing. So, yeah, really good day.
Bit of tomato and onion tuna. Really, really good. Helps you out. Socks with toes. Amazing.
If I was ever coming on this trip again, I'd probably buy 4 pairs of these.
What did you got?
4 pair, recommend if you're coming on this trip. 4 pairs of these socks.
Backwards and upwards.
10 minutes behind him. We're on.
What's the temp like, mate?
Yeah, that is just like an ice bar. I had my head under for not even 10 seconds and I got like a brain freeze. But what the bloody needs to come back and finish KOKODA, I reckon. Cheers.
Well, fuck a minute, they can you giggle at me, Jordy. Chuckling so hard.
I was about to spin it.
I thought you were going to throw it.
Go, mate.
Day 5.
Templeton's 2. Templeton's Crossing 2.
Track life, eh? Just taking it all in, eh, Geordie?
Right, you can imagine, so a lot of these trees are already gone here. Up on the other side, and we've had two battles of Euro Creek, one on our withdrawal and one on our advance, and we'll do it more when we get down there. There's an Australian foxhole just here on our right hand side as you walk past. So you can imagine
little bunker.
Being bunkered down here, flying down there so your mates can come around. They talk about that fighting withdrawal that the Australians did so well. They drop a couple in here while the rest of their mates would run behind, and once they were safe in their foxhole and putting fire behind them, they then jump out
another
and go.
Here on our right hand side, come down.
Yeah, feeling really good, Geordie. It's a beautiful morning, so, you know, where else would you want to be? I feel kind of privileged that I even got the chance to be here, so it's wonderful. I've got just the best water. Back on my trip. Fantastic. It's another fox one. It's amazing. It's so small. The two of them have been there.
There's a brand gun with the magazine over there.
Yep.
On the end. So the primer's out of the ends of the. So they're all still alive. Those mortars. Look, they've still got pins in those grenades.
Yeah. This thing's a poor bastard for like the one we should be in.
Well done, buddy.
No, well done, guys.
Well done.
Enjoy it, eh?
Paparazzi's up here.
It just gets more mind-blowing as you go, eh?
It does. It's just fabulous, you know. I've been coming up here for nearly 20 years now.
Oh, this year, how many treks you done?
I've done 22.
Holy.
But I live down in Boona. My wife was down there, and I've got a place set up here. And so, but I came up here in the 80s with the military, doing a lot of training with the Papuans.
Yeah, right, eh?
Indonesians sort of interfering on the border at the time, and it was just calm the place. All right, guys, enjoy your trip.
Which Mel told you about where all the tribes come together and that, you know, that big elaborate costumes and dress and stuff.
This guy in his headdress and this fucking like Indonesian cop like holding him up like.
I'm going to fucking end you. Right, I'm going back to the stinging nettle plant and it's a fuck. Don't encourage him.
day six, I think it was, near the end of the day. Matty said to the boys, let's have a race up this hill, see if you can beat the quarter. So I was like, no dramas. Yeah, so we'll race up this hill. Yeah, it's just a lot of ups, little downs, other groups, other quarters we had to pass, so it was pretty challenging. You can't explain it unless you've actually really seen it, to be honest. Hats off to everyone that had a crack, but yeah, I won it. That was a really hard run. How far in that was there, MJ? Oh, I don't even know how far that was, but we had a race. Uphill. Fuck, she was hectic.
Fuck. Oh, I'm going to feel that tomorrow.
Boy!
There you go. How was that, Scotty?
Yeah, good, Kenny, you?
Is the camera now? Oh, yeah, I've eaten other people now before, everyone.
Yeah, I thought so.
That hill, I'm not sure if I can pronounce it correctly, but it's... I think it's called Fuck Off Hill. They call it that because you think you're at the top and it just keeps going. Fuck off. So they named it Fuck Off Hill. True story, true story.
Well, that sums it up, mate. So that's exactly what happened.
This is what's been fueling the temple, mate. A few extras here and there from some leftovers, but this is it.
We made it. Day six.
Yep, day six. How was your day today, Geordie?
Started out pretty fatigued from the last 5 days, definitely feeling in the legs, but then just walking through the epic scenery and everything like that, and just really picked me up and realizing that it's almost over actually, so.
That's the scary part.
Yeah.
Had a nice cheeky little down and up today, didn't we?
Yeah, we did, mate. It wasn't, it wasn't all easy.
And then you want to keep rolling and just keep walking down there.
Yeah, that's right, mate.
Yeah, mate, good.
Good chipping away.
Big simo, big smile. How good.
2 days to go, two. And they're this long. Well, what a place to be. I believe this. Amazing.
On the 29th of August, the Japanese attacked with approximately 6 battalions, and they were able to fire quantities of mortars and machine gun fire in support of their attacks. Not able to answer with comparable firepower, the Australian perimeter was under severe stress and began to fall. It was during the fighting that Private Bruce Steele Kingsbury, who was a real estate agent from Melbourne, of the 2nd 14th, made an exceptional individual effort of his country and the campaign, and he was posthumously awarded the Victoria Cross as a result, the first on Australian territory. His citation read, in part, Private Kingsbury was one of the few survivors of a battalion which had been overrun. Immediately volunteered to join a different position which had been ordered to counterattack. He rushed forward, firing the Bren gun from his hip through terrific machine gun fire, and succeeded in clearing a path through the enemy. Continuing to sweep numerous enemy positions with his fire and inflicting an extremely high number of casualties upon them, Private Kingsbury was then seen to fall to the ground, shot dead by the bullet of a sniper hiding in the wood.
Bastards.
There you go, Hatchet.
Hey,
good work, boys.
Keep it going.
Keep it going.
Come past
you. Yeah, you go past. I'll go past too. Righto. Okay. Okay, good. Keep going. Yeah. Oh, look at that!
Well, you didn't do that to Tours, did you?
Nah, she would have fucking literally had a heart
attack. Boy, I told her there's no snakes over here. Right? She's fucking terrified of fucking
snakes.
Like not a big climb, just hot.
Thanks, yeah. I say.
Pretty hot and humid, isn't it? A bit.
And that's KOKODA straight down there. That's KOKODA airstrip.
Just down there.
Straight down.
Love the hat, Em.
It's bright, isn't it? I tried to give it to Thomas. He was like, no thank you, Emily, it's too pink. The boys will tease me.
I'm ready for a treat. Lunchtime.
Happy noon.
All right. Good luck.
One more.
Good luck, good luck. Happy noon.
You stop by, eh?
Good.
You just rely.
Yes, yes.
Just
look and then follow the
the
line.
So you don't use the guide.
The line is there.
Yeah. Look, they're kind of completely rough.
So we put the line in.
And
then he just does it by hand then.
Yeah. Can I pick that up?
Yeah.
Pick him up?
Yeah.
Can I lift?
Yeah.
Can I lift?
You can, like, lift up.
Holy.
You're heavy?
Yeah, man. Wow, feel that. Oh! Dude, that's your proper old school, mate, in Germany, the whole kit there. Thank you,
Get the 3x2 and the 4x2.
Oh, I see, you've been going 3x2, 4x2. Yeah.
We cut the...
It's fucking
epic. Righto then, look him up.
Yeah.
Yes. Come back, we'll come back.
Couple of Rothmans. Or rave.
Blue eye, mustard and lime then. Get it for the boys or what? How much for the lime?
That's a free one and this one's a 20 pair. 20 pair.
22.
Yeah.
You want to scrub 52.
15 mustard.
2 keener. Can I grab 2 mustard? Can I bring the boys back to the line, huh? That's okay, huh? Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Put it in the lime and then put it in and bite that off and mix it all together.
A little bit like that, a little bit there.
Yeah, just bite it off. You can keep it in your mouth. And chew it into a paste. Don't swallow it.
Yeah, it's massive.
Smush. You got the mustard. Just bite the end of that off.
Not good.
You're red?
No.
Yeah.
I'm not. Oh, it's not very good.
Makes your mouth, I'll just swallow a bit, makes your mouth numb.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, see. The taste of it.
You can't do anything.
It's like a sour lemon. Okay. Yeah, I wouldn't do it all the time.
This is how you do it? Yeah. Let's look inside and then two or three times of this, you get it, then you start to mix it up, all fit together, 20 seconds, 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Start to feel a bit energy.
Yeah. That's it.
All right.
It's used normally by elders in the villages. They sit around for meetings or gatherings, they chew bitter nut, put a dish or a basket of bitter nut on the table and then get one each and then they start to chew and then start to talk, have a meeting or something like that. Hola.
That's fine.
Fire.
We wouldn't be able to do it without your help, and that's on behalf of everybody here. So be proud of the people that you are, in the footsteps of the Fuzzy Wuzzies, and be proud of what we've achieved. And we would not be able to do it without you, and we just want to say thank you, boys.
Harry, mate, she's over, buddy.
We did it. We got through it all.
Awesome. So good.
Yeah. Finishing in good spirits, too. Heaps of smiles.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well done, mate. Well done.
See, mate.
Didn't think you'd get here.
No, I didn't.
No, well, look, here you are, mate.
Thanks for putting up with me.
If you had to pick one, what would be the highlight of the trip for you?
It'd be now, I suppose, sitting around knowing that we've just got a flat walk to KOKODA, to the airstrip. We made it.